Suchana Seth is currently facing charges for the alleged killing of her 4-year-old son at a service apartment in Goa. Shocking details have emerged, suggesting that Suchana's strained relationship with her estranged husband, Venkatraman, played a significant role in the tragic incident. Reportedly, Suchana had conveyed to friends and family that her son's resemblance to her husband constantly reminded her of their troubled marriage. In a disturbing turn of events, Suchana messaged Venkatraman, proposing a meeting with their son on Sunday, January 7 in Bangalore. However, it appears that she had no intention of allowing the meeting as her booking in Goa extended from January 6 to January 10. Venkat, unaware of her plans, arrived at the specified location in Bangalore but received no response from Suchana. Consequently, he proceeded to Jakarta for work, as mentioned in an Indian Express report. Suchana Seth, aged 39, is now undergoing a psychological examination as authorities attempt to piece together the events leading to her arrest in Karnataka with her son's lifeless body discovered in a bag. Police sources reveal that she has exhibited no remorse for her son's death and has been uncooperative during questioning. Furthermore, she attempted suicide, evident from slash marks on her wrist shortly after what appears to be a premeditated murder. During interrogation, Suchana claimed ignorance about her son's death, asserting that he was alive when she went for a nap and found lifeless upon waking. However, law enforcement dismisses this explanation, considering it implausible. Suchana has admitted to the strained relationship with her husband, Venkatraman, currently residing in Indonesia. The couple is reportedly in the final stages of divorce, with a court order granting visitation rights to Venkat, triggering distress in Suchana, leading to the alleged murder. Suchana had sought 2.5 lakh rupees per month as maintenance after the divorce, accusing Venkatraman of domestic violence in a separate case filed in August the previous year. A restraining order had been issued against him, prohibiting any form of contact with his wife. Meanwhile, Venkatraman, who will be summoned for investigation in the coming days, denies all domestic abuse charges, including those involving physical assault on both Suchana and their deceased son. The child was laid to rest in Bangalore on Wednesday, with his name withheld as a mark of respect.